This is Janet Androvier.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain the concept of the magnetic flux, indicate the direction of the unit vector and normal to the plane of a wire loop, define a uniform magnetic field, give the expression of the magnetic flux crossing a coil placed in a uniform magnetic field, relate the sign of the magnetic flux to the direction of the unit vector and solve an example about the calculation of the magnetic flux.
Let's introduce a new physical quantity called magnetic flux. This physical quantity is usually denoted by the Greek letter phi. When we think about the magnetic flux crossing a surface, we talk about the field lines flowing through the surface. First, we care about the component of the magnetic field that is normal to the surface. In figures A, B, and C, a wire loop is placed in a magnetic field B, having parallel field lines. In figure A, the field lines are normal to the surface, so the magnetic flux crossing this loop is phi1. In figure B, we incline the loop, but we care about the component of B that is normal to the surface of this loop, so the flux crossing this loop now is phi2 less than phi1. In figure C, the field lines go along the surface of the loop and not through the surface, so the magnetic flux crossing this loop now is phi3 equal to 0. Second, we care about the area of the loop. In figure D, we replace the loop of figure A by another loop having a larger area S prime. So S prime is greater than S. Then more field lines cross this loop of same angle. So the magnetic flux crossing this loop is phi4 greater than phi1. Third, we care about the strength of the magnetic field. In figure E, we place the loop of figure A in a stronger magnetic field B prime. So the magnitude of B prime is greater than that of B. So the magnetic flux crossing this loop now is phi5 greater than phi1.
The unit vector N is a unit vector which is normal to the plane of a conducting loop. The direction of N depends on the chosen positive sense. If you curl the fingers of your right hand in the positive sense, then your thumb would point in the direction of N. The specification of the direction of N is explained in detail in the next experiment.
In this video, we are going to explain how to specify the direction of the unit vector N normal to the plane of a conducting loop. But first, I want to remind you how to draw the vector if it is directed outwards or inwards. Now look at this vector. Now if the vector is directed outwards away from the board, you are looking at the vector, you will see the tip of the vector. So this vector is drawn as a dot. While if the vector is inwards, it is directed into the board, you will see the tail of the vector, so this vector is drawn as a cross. Now, let's move to our experiment. So here we have conducting loops. I will use this one. Now, we want to specify the direction of the unit vector N. First, I will place the loop in the horizontal plane. Now, the method is like that. First, be careful. Use your right hand. You do not use your left hand. So, using your right hand, curl your fingers with the chosen positive sense, your thumb will point to the direction of N. So let's start with the first figure. In this figure, the chosen positive sense is like that, and so the thumb points to the unit vector, which is vertical upward. So this is the unit vector. We draw it from the center of the loop. Now, the second case, the loop is still in the horizontal plane, and now the positive sense is directed this way. In this case, this is the direction of N. It is vertical downward. So this is N. After finishing the cases of the horizontal plane, I will place the loop now in the vertical plane. Now, the chosen positive sense is counterclockwise. So I will curl the fingers of my right hand with the chosen positive sense, and this is N. Look at the unit vector N. It is directed outwards. So you will see the tip of the vector. So this vector is drawn as a dot. So this is N. While in this case, the positive sense is directed clockwise, and you curl your fingers with the positive sense and the thumb points inwards. So the unit vector N is directed inwards. So it is drawn as a cross. Now also we can place, for example, the loop on an inclined plane. We will follow the same procedure. If the positive sense is like that, then the thumb points upward, perpendicular to the surface of the inclined plane. And if the positive sense is like that, so the thumb points downward in a direction perpendicular to the inclined plane, which means that the unit vector is downward, perpendicular, or normal to the inclined plane.
Uniform magnetic field. A magnetic field is said to be uniform in a certain region if at any instant it has the same magnitude and the same direction at all points of this region. On the shown figure, the magnetic field is uniform. So, the magnetic field at A be A, and BD at D, and BC at C have the same direction and the same magnitude. Pay attention in order not to confuse. Uniform magnetic field means it is constant with the position and it is not necessarily constant with the time. Now, let's take examples about uniform magnetic field. The magnetic field between the poles of a U-shaped magnet can be considered uniform. And the magnetic field which is created by a solenoid is uniform inside this solenoid and away from its ends.
Now, we are ready to discuss the magnetic flux crossing a loop placed in a uniform magnetic field. Consider the figure. A wire loop is placed in the vertical plane in a horizontal uniform magnetic field B. The magnetic flux crossing the loop due to this magnetic field is given by B dot and S. Now, recall that the dot product of two vectors is the product of their magnitudes times the cosine of the angle between them. So this is going to be the magnitude of B times the magnitude of N, which is 1 because it is a unit vector, times S times cosine the angle between B and N. This is going to be B times S times cosine alpha. The angle between B and N is called alpha. Now, B is the magnitude of the uniform magnetic field, and remember its SI unit is Tesla. S is the area of the loop and its SI unit is meter squared. N is the unit vector normal to the plane of the loop, as you know, and alpha is the angle between B and N. But what is the SI unit of the magnetic flux phi? Its SI unit is Weber.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, magnetic flux crossing a coil of N identical loops. This flux is equal to the flux crossing one loop multiplied by the number of loops. Therefore, the magnetic flux is given by capital N into B scalar small n times S, which is equal to NBS cosine, the angle between B and N. The angle between B and N can be denoted by the letter alpha. From this expression, we can conclude that the flux could be positive, negative, or zero because it depends on the direction of the unit vector N. Let's study three cases. First case, if alpha greater than or equal zero and less than pi over 2 as shown on the figure. We know that when alpha varies between 0 and pi over 2, cosine alpha is greater than zero. By referring to the expression of phi, N times B times s is always positive. But now, cosine alpha positive, therefore the sign of the flux crossing this loop is positive. Second case, for alpha equal pi over 2, that means the magnetic field is parallel to the surface. Therefore, cosine pi over 2 is equal to 0. Then, the flux crossing the loop is equal to 0. Third case, if alpha greater than pi over 2 and less than or equal to pi, as shown on the third figure, then cosine alpha is negative. By referring to the expression of phi, NBS is positive and cosine alpha negative, therefore the flux crossing the loop has a negative value.
Now, let's solve an application about the calculation of the magnetic flux. This figure shows a solenoid M whose axis makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. The solenoid of 500 turns is placed in a uniform magnetic field B whose lines are horizontal. The magnitude of B is 0.5 tesla and the area of each loop is 20 centimeters squared. Part 1a. Calculate the value of the magnetic flux phi crossing M. So phi is given by NSB dot N, and B dot N gives you the magnitude of B times the magnitude of N, which is 1, times cosine, the angle between B and N. But first, what is the angle between B and N? As you know, curl your fingers with the positive sense. Then your thumb would point to the direction of the unit vector N. So, what is the angle between N and B? Alpha is the angle between N and B. Alpha and 30 are corresponding angles, so alpha is equal to 30 degrees. Now we are ready to calculate phi. Replace each physical quantity by its value. So the number of turns is 500 and B is equal to 0.5 tesla. And the area of each loop is equal to 20 centimeters squared. So you divide by 10 thousandths, so it becomes 20 times 10 to the power minus 4 meters squared. Cosine 30, and the answer is pi is equal to 0.217 Weber.
Number 2. The axis of M is rotated clockwise in the vertical plane by an angle of 60 degrees. Clockwise means in this sense. Determine the value of the magnetic flux phi prime crossing M. The figure shows that the axis of the solenoid becomes perpendicular to B, so the angle alpha between B and N is equal to 90 degrees. Using the expression of the flux, phi prime is equal to NBS cosine alpha, which is equal to 90 degrees now. Therefore, the magnetic flux crossing the coil is equal to zero. When the flux crossing the coil is zero, that means B has no component normal to the surface of each loop.
Now, part 3. The positive sense is reversed. Calculate again the value of the initial magnetic flux crossing M. Look at the figure. Curl the fingers of your right hand with the positive sense. And this is the new unit vector N. Alpha is the angle between B and N. But look, alpha and 30 degrees are supplementary angles, so they add up to 180 degrees. So the angle between B and N is equal to 180 minus 30, which is equal to 150 degrees. Now we are ready to calculate the new magnetic flux. So the number of turns is 500. The magnitude of B is 0.25 tesla. The area of each loop is equal to 20 times 10 to the power minus 4 meters squared. And the angle alpha is 150 degrees. And the answer is minus 0.217 Weber.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.